Let's put this funny guy in here. So this one was ground on the belt sander too. Can come back and we can use our square again. That looks real good. Real nice. That looks pretty close. Close enough to try right off the bat. Extra coarse wheel, extra coarse stone, I mean. Apologize. Take a couple licks. That is. Finally, I got one on the first try. I'm right here on the back, taking it all the way to that front edge, and few more strokes and we'll have this one clean faceted again. I still have a little corner here at the front that I need to get rid of. Let me straighten it out here. When I first discovered that cutting fluids worked so much better than just straight water, I was using this product called Relton Option 1, which is an awesome cutting fluid. It's biodegradable and doesn't leave a rust residue on your tools. And I kept smelling it and kept thinking that smell smelled awfully familiar. And then it finally dawned on me that it smelled like Simple Green. And that's what spurred me to, now that's completely clean all the way across the front. That's what spurred me to try my Simple Green and water concoction that that I use now. Because I thought that, well, they must have similar ingredients in it to be so, smell so much alike. And I did the experiment with the Simple Green in water and I've never gone back. And I know Simple Green is, it's considered a food grade cleanser. You can have it around food products and stuff. So I'm not worried about getting it on my hands. And it's, the price is a fraction of what it was buying that dedicated cutting fluid. I can buy a gallon of it at Home Depot for about $9 and I cut it 50-50 with water and it lasts a long time. Plus I use it all the time when my hands are really grimy. I just spray this mix on my hands and pre-wash my hands using that before I go in and foul the sink up in my house. Okay, so this is coarse. I knocked the burr off it at fine. This one it will be a little bit harder to do the side to side, although it can still be done. You may not be able to do it quite as fast, or you may rock a little bit. But see, since this has these two nice flat wheels on the back, this really stays. When you put pressure on it, it really stays stable. Very stable to do that. I can't do it backwards, I would show you. Alright, that's completely perfect and ready to have the burr knocked off again. Wow, I really see that piece of wire really well this time. Pretty big hunk came off. So I'm gonna put the fine into the jig sharpening location. We'll just take a few passes to going. There's my burr already. Extra fine. All right, this one's ready now too. Loosen that up a little bit extra to hold it out of the way. Hold it out of the way, carefully take it out. And there's a perfectly sharp Japanese chisel right there.